What's up, YouTube? This is Disposable 762, and we're at the reloading bench. So sit back, relax, and enjoy the show. What's up, YouTube? Just before the video starts, I'd like to promote my new t-shirt store at tpublic.com. At tpublic.com's website, if you go to the search bar and type in Disposable 762, you'll be able to find my t-shirt designs there. And I appreciate the business. I appreciate y'all watching these videos. I appreciate y'all subscribing. And I really would like to sell y'all some t-shirts, phone cases, stickers, whatever the case may be. You can select your different colors. You don't have to get these colors. You can get whatever color you want. And sizes and women's sizes and stuff like that. These are just a couple of examples of my t-shirts that I figured I would come and show y'all. So I appreciate your business. I appreciate you watching the videos, and I appreciate your support. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, and we're gone. So what's up, guys? This is Disposable 762, and if you hadn't noticed, been cleaning up the shop a little bit, straightening up a little bit, getting rid of some stuff, and came across this little box of Ideal Gas Checks. They're 30 caliber, and I had this mold here for a 308 caliber round, and I'm thinking to myself, I have me old 308 bolt gun, and I was going to give this a try. I was going to, let's see, about half of them. I think I got a baker's dozen here, so I'm going to take about half of them and gas check them, and then I'm going to take the other half, and I'm not going to gas check them, and I'm going to work me up a powder load. I'm going to see what they recommend for a 308 cast bullet with some trail boss, and see what kind of loads we can work up, maybe take some of this deer hunting this year. Yeah, the hurricane's going through right now, and right now it's just wind and rain. So while I still got power and electricity, and you know, bored to death up there in the house, I figured I'd come down here and do some reloading. There you go. Got six rounds there, gas checked. I'll probably shoot a group for three, and then save those three to hunt with if they'll group all right. And these here, I'm just going to leave them bare and just shoot them out of that old rifle. All right, so we got our scale out here. Here's our un-gas check bullets. 159, 1583, 1586, 1588, 157. So that one's a light feller there. He looks frosty too. That's what a gas check bullet goes for. 162, 164, 1627, 1623, 1622, 1626. So that number 13 there, he's 157. So I'm gonna melt him back down. I don't think he's just way too far out of the ballpark, and plus he wasn't a good cast either. That's probably one of the first ones. So we're going to resize and prime some 308 brass here. All right, so now we have 12 rounds that we've resized and primed. So now what I want to do, I want to set 10 grains of trail boss. I don't know what this scoop weighs out to be, but that's about full. Ten point one grains trail boss gas check bullet. Let's check the overall length. So it should be 281. So I'm gonna mark this bullet G for gas. Ten grains trail boss. But this here, I just, you know, I don't think we're working up a subsonic load. This is only about a 70% charge for this case. That's a good starting range from what I've read, what I've understood. And I just I'm just curious to see what these gas checks will do. Mainly the only reason why I'm doing this, just an experiment for my behalf. So there you go, 6 gas checked 308 Winchesters. Now we're going to do these non-gas check bullets. All right, so now we have 12 rounds that we have loaded with 10 grains of trail boss. These with the G are marked as gas checked, and these do are not gas checked. That's a pretty good crimp right there. And I left that there. I didn't know whether I should or not, but I left that little lip right there. I'm within overall length, so that might be a pretty heavy crimp on those guys. But we'll see what happens. There we go. We got a dozen 308 shells, and we're going to see what kind of accuracy, or if any difference in accuracy with those shells. So next time you see us, we'll be at the gun range. What's up, guys? We're here at the range now, and this is the rifle I was talking about. This is a Winchester Model 70 Post 64. I have not zeroed this rifle with these new sights, so I got 4 rounds of some factory hunting ammunition that we're going to put on target. All right, so we've zeroed the rifle. That sight was out way far. Took me a few rounds to get it where I wanted it. So what we've got here, the marks that are red were my zeroing shots. I couldn't even find paper, so I had to put that one there. And then my next one was here. And then I wanted it right on the line so I could see it there. So right now the rifle is zeroed at 25 yards. This side, the left side, is going to be gas checked. This side is not. So we have 6 gas checked and 6 that aren't. And we're going to fire a shot, a group of 3. I've been having a little bit of issues with this extractor on this bolt. Dead center of the black. That's 10 grains trail boss. Sounds like a 22. Now 3 rounds without being gas checked. Go see the difference. So here we go, guys. This is the 3 shot group with the gas check bullets. This is the 3 shot group without gas check bullets. So what I'm looking at here is that yes, it will work anything past 25 yards. You're gonna be hard pressed to hit it without a gas check bullet. I'm disposable 7.62. Remember, every knee shall bow and every tongue shall confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. And we're gone.